And Pratik is going to present the case. He is a third year resident at LTMJ Sion.
इसका चार्जर का है ब्रिंग
प्रतीक ओवर
यस सर यस
चार्जर
देयर इज वन प्रेजेंटर प्रतीक सो एंड चैनल एक्सपेक्टेड टू अस हिम आल्सो चंद्रिका ओके बट यू इज प्रतीक
एंड माय पीपीटी इज गोइंग टू बी शेयर्ड फ्रॉम देयर
We are sharing because whatever the things we ask, we project. We are not projecting complete scenario at the outset. Yeah.
Everyone, I am going to present a case of lump in abdomen. First slide. A 3-year-old female child was brought by parents with chief complaint of swelling in the upper abdomen since 8 days. Patient was apparently all right 8 days back when the parents noticed a swelling in the upper abdomen. Which was since 8 days. Swelling was associated with dull aching pain which got relieved with medication, no aggravating factors. Swelling was initially small in size and gradually increased to the present size. Patient didn't pass motion for last 4 days for which the patient was taken to a private practitioner. There the private practitioner had given enema and the patient had passed stools and had advised a USG abdomen, the findings of which were noted and the patient was referred to the higher center for further management. Patient gives history of multiple such episodes in the past 1 year, which got relieved on medication. No history of vomiting, fever, diarrhea. Next slide. No history of weight loss, no history of trauma, no history of jaundice or clay colored stools, no history of bleeding per rectum, malina, hematemesis, no history of signs of liver failure. Treatment history. Patient had undergone open inguinal hernia repair 1 year back. Since then, the patient is complaining of pain in abdomen. Patient has undergone USG abdomen and CT scan outside for the same. Past history, no significant finding, no contributory family history. Birth history is within normal limits, 2.8 kg, full-term normal vaginal delivery. Baby cried immediately after birth. No NICU stay, passed urine and meconium within 24 hours of life. Developmental history, no history of any developmental delay. Patient is immunized till date. And ANC history, no history of any abnormality in the ANC scans. This is the clinical picture of the baby. On general examination.
Hold on, Pratik.
Yes, sir.
So, if I may ask you.
Yes, sir.
Just summarize your case. What are the salient positive things that you have got? And can you reach at some conclusion as to what likely you are going to see in general examination and in local examination? What are your guesses from the history?
Yes, sir. So this is a 3-year-old female child which has come with intermittent history of pain in abdomen for the last 1 year post her open inguinal hernia repair. And she is on the basis of my history, there is no gastrointestinal complaints and no fever. So I am looking at based on the location of the mass, that is upper abdomen, which they have suggested, my differentials on the basis of just the history, so it can be an.
I'm not asking at differentials, okay. But I do not buy your statement that there has been no GI complaint at all, because if I heard you right,
yes,
you
sir.
Said that patient had multiple recurrent episodes of abdominal pain.
Yes,
for
yes,
a span of as long as one year for
yes,
which she has received treatment. So
yes,
I would place it as a pathology that has been ongoing for last at least few months to a year at the most,
yes,
with recurrent episodes of pain the antecedent history of inguinal hernia repair may not be relevant in an index case because this seems to be an upper abdominal swelling rather than anything in the lower abdomen. You did not comment on the relative swelling, whether this is on the right side, middle part or left part. So I presume that the entire upper part of the abdomen has been probably occupied by this particular swelling. So the story does tell me something, that this is a chronic condition or at least a subacute condition. It hasn't got any relevance with any history of trauma or altered bowel habits and anything. Though altered bowel habits in the upper part of abdomen will be less likely to be asked, but no history of vomiting has been a conspicuous finding. This is what I would confer from the story till just now. Go ahead.
So I'll come to examination.
Suppose yes, this is a lower abdominal lump going for 1 year with a history of surgery for hernia.
Okay, sir.
What condition will come in your mind?
A lower
abdominal lump with a history of surgery for hernia, and the lump is there for 1 year and not causing my symptoms. Some abdominal pathology which is pushing the contents, causing the hernia, and it is large lymphangiomas can present like abdominal inguinal hernia.
Okay.
And lymphangiomas can remain asymptomatic for years. Proceed.
On general examination, patient is conscious, oriented, alert, lying comfortably in bed, pulse of 98 per minute, blood pressure of 94/48 millimeters of mercury within 50th percentile. Weight of the baby was 10 kgs, which is between 50th and 95th percentile, and length was 80.
prepare it on that.
Thank you.
पढ़ना आ गया ऐसे ही घर में कैसे?